Hello people, this is Self-Tuts and we are continuing our series on Vagrant for beginners, and in this video we'll see how to set memory for your Vagrant virtual machine. So by default 512 MB of memory is provided to your virtual machine by VirtualBox and Vagrant, but in some cases you may need more than 512 MB of memory, or you may want to decrease the memory from 512 MB. Suppose you are having a virtual machine which has installation of Java, it is running more than 2 Java application, and then it is also running MongoDB and MySQL and some Node application. So for that particular machine, you will need more than 512 MB of memory. So in this video, we'll see how to set the memory for your Vagrant virtual machine. So I'm using a Linux box, and to see what is my memory configuration or how much memory is present inside my Linux box or Linux virtual machine, I have to fire a command that is free -m. So I'll go to my Vagrant machine, and this is the Vagrant machine. I am inside it. I have done Vagrant SSH and I am present inside my virtual machine. So I'll fire the command free -m, and this will show me the memory, that is a total of 488 MB. So when we assign 512 MB, some memory are used by the system. So here a total of 488 MB is being shown, and out of which 70 is used and 271 MB is free. Now I want to increase the memory of my virtual machine to 2000 MB. So what I have to do? I have to do some configuration, and the configuration is something like this, that you have to provide a vb.memory key inside the configuration of your provider. So this is a provider level configuration, and the provider that we are using is VirtualBox. So what you have to do, you have to use config.vm.provider, and all the configuration related to provider like memory, CPU, name, etc. goes inside this section. So what I will do, I'll go to my Vagrant virtual machine and I'll do a exit. So after doing exit, I can do ls, and this is the host machine. So the ls command that I'm firing is inside my host machine. So the ls command shows that a Vagrant file is present, and I'll do my configuration inside the Vagrant file. So I'll open the Vagrant file, and you can see this is the current configuration, that I'm using a CentOS 7 box, and I'm using a private network which is having a IP of 172.18.0.101. So doing the configuration in Vagrant file is important, because when we reload your system, then Vagrant reads this configuration file, that is Vagrant file, and applies the configuration to your virtual machine. So what I'll do, I'll write the configuration, that is config.vm.provider, and the provider that we are using is VirtualBox. And what I have to do, I have to write do and then pipe vb. This is the common syntax, so you need not to worry about this syntax at present. And then I have to write that the vb.memory, that is the memory that I'll be providing, will be equal to 2000 MB. So I'll provide a space here just for better reading purpose. So we'll see that I have written the exact same thing, that is the configuration is this, without any spelling mistake. If there's some spelling mistake, then the configuration will not be loaded, and I'm having a spelling mistake here. So config.vm.provider and then VirtualBox 2vb, and the memory is 2000 MB. So I'll do write and quit, that I'm writing the file, and what I'll do, I will reload my Vagrant. So I have fired the command Vagrant reload. So Vagrant reload is important, because when you do some changes in the configuration of your Vagrant machine, then you need to reload it so that the new configuration is applied to your virtual machine. So when we fire the command Vagrant reload, what it will do, it will first try to do a graceful shutdown of your virtual machine. Why graceful shutdown is important? Because if you're doing some work, then it should be saved and no data is lost. Then what we'll do, it will fire the Vagrant up process that we have seen before, and during that Vagrant up process, it will clear the set forwarded ports, it will do some network configuration that you have done, it will do the SSH configuration, and this 2222 port is on the host, that is our Windows machine, and the 22 port is inside our vagrant machine. So it is doing all the configuration. The machine is booted and ready, and it is enabling the network interfaces, and it will try to vagrant up everything. Now the machine is up and running. So I'll go inside it. I'll do vagrant SSH, and it will take me to the vagrant machine. So I'm inside my vagrant machine. I'll type clear so that everything is visible clearly. And again, I'll fire the command free minus m. And this time you can see the total memory has been increased. So I have provided a memory of 2000 MB. So some memory have been used. So the total memory currently showing is 1971. So previously it was showing 488 MB. So we have seen that changing inside the vagrant file and providing a configuration of vb.memory and then writing the memory in MB, it has changed the memory that the current virtual machine is using. So this was all about how to change memory in for your virtual machine in vagrant. So you can see that it is very much easy to do the configuration in your vagrant file and then reload it to apply all those changes. So thank you very much. If you like my channel, please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, please give a